What's going on, everybody? It's Josh with Be Known. It is a little bit late, and I apologize for that. I didn't forget about you guys in the weekend inspiration. I've been working on a whole bunch of stuff today. Man, talk about a big glows Friday. It's been great. So I got a few things I want to talk to you guys about, and in order to kind of keep the scenery different, I was out here while I was on the phone, pulling off some last-minute stuff, you know, making some good contacts, making some cool stuff happen. I'm actually sitting here in the garage with my bike, taking a look at it, really hoping to get it running, but you know, building your own stuff, it takes a while, so you know, it is what it is. So for, I got a couple of cool announcements actually. So I wanted to talk about one thing that is work related. So we actually got handpicked, hand selected, if you will, to run a pilot platform, like a beta version, for a company. Now, if you're a real estate agent, if you're one of our clients, if you're one of the agents that follow us and you haven't decided to work with us yet, pay close attention. This right here is a really, really cool program. I'm not going to talk about what it is because we're running the beta tests on it right now. So we're going to be involved highly in that, but it is for property search, for getting data for homeowners and things like that. So this is a vital tool. If you know what Remine is, it's a similar platform, but on a kind of, so far from what we found, it looks like it's on an even better level and a little bit better data. So, you know, stay tuned for that. If you want to know more about it, feel free to contact me. If you don't know what Remine is and you want to know about both platforms, we love Remine. We use it too. So feel free to contact me and I'd be happy to talk to you more about that as well. So really, really great stuff on that. The second platform that I want to talk to you guys about, now this is for anybody who's a business owner, okay? It doesn't matter what business you're in. Especially though, if it has to do with you're selling something, this is really, really beneficial. So I see all the time in like Facebook groups and social media stuff and things like that where somebody's saying, what do I give for a closing gift? I wanna give my client a closing gift, what do I give? Blah, blah, blah. Well, I started looking at this platform and it's called Banner Scene, right? Let me check that. Let's check it out real quick. We just signed up for it, so I'm not even hiring. Banner Season, that's what it was, my fault. See, even I mess up. Banner Season, I'm gonna get back over here in the light so you guys can see me. Banner Season is what it's called, and it's a great platform. We signed up for it just the other day. We started taking a look at it. It's really, really great. What you're gonna wanna do is sign up for the Gold, and that's the membership you're gonna want. It's only $49 when you go through us, okay, guys? And it waives like a whole $300 setup. It gives you some access to like some free postcard mailers and stuff like that. There's a lot of really cool stuff you can do with it. Go check it out. I'll put the link in the comments for you guys, but here's where it's really, really beneficial is you can do stuff. So for example, let's take it like this. Let's imagine this for a second. Let's say you're a car salesman, or let's say you own the dealership, right? And somebody comes in, they buy a new car, and you're like, man, I really want to give them a great gift. You obviously have their information and stuff like that. You're going to have to send them stuff. So why not send them a gift that says thank you, but also keeps your name top priority? And that's the biggest thing in sales, especially with like, doing real estate, car sales. I mean, the list goes on in sales, is keeping yourself top priority, top of mind, right? Keeping yourself the top of mind so that every time they think about what it is, whatever industry you're in, they think of you. So how do we do that? Well, we do that with a simple gift. And we're gonna start doing this. We ordered some for ourselves. They came here stupid quick too. So we went ahead and ordered a couple of coffee mugs. So think about this, we have a client that comes on, they're great. We love what they're doing. They have us dial in all the systems, have us do all this stuff, and boom, we wanna get them a gift. So for yourself, let's say you're selling home or selling a car. So car sales, we'll go back to that. I'll ramble off, sorry. We're gonna go back to the car sales. You get them the gift, right? You send it to them with your logo on it and your name or something like that, right? Put the car dealership logo, the kind of car they bought, whatever logo you wanna put on there and your name or something like that. And in the morning, they're gonna take that coffee cup, they're gonna put it in their cupboard with the other coffee cups. But every time they go to open that coffee cup cupboard up, they're gonna see that. And that keeps you top of mind. So the next time they have a friend talking about buying a car, they're thinking they need to buy another one because, for some reason the wife needs one, the husband needs one, whatever reason it is, a family member, whatever, their top priority and their thinking is already set on coming to see you because They got a coffee mug. Now, it's not about the coffee mug. What it's about is people have short-term memory. You know, everybody has short-term memory. I get talked to about it all the time. Like, hey, I've been a real estate agent for you know, 2 years, and I'm so irritated today because my sister and just got married, and they decided to buy a house, and, you know, they used a different agent. Why didn't they use me? And I go, well, when's the last time you reminded them that you do real estate? I mean, that's really what it's about is, that, you know, that can just skip their general thought process, you know? So let's keep your name top of mind by doing something as simple as banner season, okay? For $49, you get to go out a gold membership. It's going to waive all the $300 startup, all the other stuff. You're going to get some free stuff like some postcard mailers, things like that. But for $10, check this out. $10, coffee mug, Be Known Advertising's logo and name right on it. You know, so when I send that out to somebody, you know, they're getting a coffee mug with that. They're reminded about us. And you know what? Somebody, we have a colleague over because, you know, they can't really go to an office right now with everything that's going on. Colleague comes over. Hey, let's have some coffee. Hey, what's that Be Known Advertising thing? Oh, man, you need some marketing and advertising. These are my guys. You should use them. And boom, there's shining the spotlight right there on you. So that's the thing. Guys, definitely check it out. At least click the link and just go check out what it is and what it can do for you. It has a whole bunch of really cool stuff. They have all kinds of customizable gifts, things like that. So I'm giving a great plug for them because, you know, we found it. It's going to be something super beneficial for us. It's not costing us an arm and a leg and trying to find where we can get them a specialty gift, you know, anything like that. It's just we have all that access through this now for $49. You know, it's crazy. So check it out. The link will be in the comments, okay? Sign up for it. You're going to want to do it. No matter what industry you're in, it's a great, great gift. You know, great thing to be able to give out some gifts to people, especially in the times we're in right now. Just that smallest thing can set you apart from everybody else in the industry you're in. So definitely check that out. Okay, so enough of that. I want to give a quick shout out to a local business right now too, to Grouchy's Barbershop here in Fallon, Nevada, for, you know, my man Billy, keeping out on my hair looking good all the time, keeps the beard done. This is an old school style barbershop. It's a lot of fun. You go in there, you got some movies playing, some action movies up on the flat screen. You can have yourself a Coke, or you can have, you know, a shot of whiskey or some whiskey on the rocks, sit there, get a straight razor cut, shave, hot towel, all that stuff, and a great haircut. I mean, I get asked all the time how my hair looks good, how my beard looks so good. It's not me, you guys. It's Grouchy's. It's Billy and Billy over there, okay? So, guys, hey, thank you very much. I want to give a shout-out to local business. That's going to be something I'm going to really start doing, is giving those shout-outs. So if you're around here, if you're in Reno, if you're in Fallon, if you're in Fernley, if you're anywhere near here, you know, give them a call. Set your appointment. It is by appointment only, you guys. So give them a call. Look them up on the interwebs. Give them a call. They do a great, phenomenal job. And that's coming from somebody I spent quite a few years when I moved over here to Nevada trying to find the right person to cut my hair, because I'm really, really meticulous about who touches, you know, my hair and my beard and stuff. So they do a great job. Check them out. You're going to love them. Let's see. One more project I was working on. This is going to be fun, you guys. Look forward to this. We're going to have a really, really fun side project that we're doing. We're going to do some stuff with guns and ammo. Now, I got contacted by a gentleman. I'm not going to drop any names or any company names right now, but I want you to look forward to having some cool stuff on there, and I'll drop you guys a link when it's ready to go where you can order your ammo. And I know right now it is a really, really hard time to, you know, find anything firearm related. Now, obviously, you can't order a gun and get it through the mail, so don't worry. I know the legalities of it, but you can place an order for ammo, and, you know, with a lot of the stores not carrying it or being out of it all the time, this is the perfect time for a company like this to come along and contact a company like ourselves to help make them known, right? That's our whole point, be known. So we want them to be known. So as soon as we're ready to go, we're gonna start launching some of that stuff. We're gonna put some fun videos on here. We're gonna have some fun stuff of, you know, going out, shooting a couple of guns, a couple of the tactical courses. We're gonna have that stuff. We're gonna be launching a YouTube channel for them so you can check it out. You know, there's gonna be like some training for the kids, things like that, you know, which I think is really great, because I feel that, like, in my house, if there's kids that have actually gone out and shot a gun, that have got to hold it, that feel the power of that, you know, even if it's a little 22 pistol to a little 5-year-old kid, you know, that's a boomstick to them. So, you know, they're going to be way less likely to mess with that while you're not paying attention, or while you're taking a nap, or, you know how kids are. You lose track of them for 30 seconds and they're getting into something. I feel that, you know, actual, you know, knowledge and showing them that, you know, this is a dangerous tool. Yes, this is something that can hurt somebody. Yes, this is something that is also good for things. And, you know, let's go out. I'll show you how to shoot it, and we'll teach you how to do all the stuff. And that's that right there is just that kind of educational system, I feel like, has always been something that, you know, keeps back from kids going and grabbing the gun out of your sock drawer or something like that while you're sleeping. And that's when accidents happen, obviously. So we want to do our part to put out a lot of safety for this company, as well as putting out a lot of fun content. So look forward to that. And as soon as we have it, I'll drop the link so you guys can make orders. So, I mean, it's been a crazy eventful day, right? So for our weekend inspiration, I'll finally get to it. I think that, you know, one of the things that I really wanted to touch base on, besides just the staying top of mind, like with the, you know, the GIF again from Banner Seasons, those are really cool. They help stay top of mind. But I really wanted to talk about, I guess you would call it stereotypes, maybe, pigeonholing. I mean, we've called it all kinds of things, but it's that when you walk into a place of business, and let's take, for example, like say you walk into a Nordstrom's or something like that, and you know, the people there, they're salespeople, the people that work there, you know, their job is to try and help you out and get you to buy some more stuff. So when they look at you, when you walk in, and let's say you're just wearing some dirty raggedy kicks and you know, your jeans are all dirty and tore up and your sweater's all tore up and things like that, they tend to stereotype or pigeonhole you that you are somebody who doesn't have money to spend there. So why should they waste their time trying to help you? And you know, the same thing can go the other way around. You could have no money to your name, literally, you know, have $5 to your name, but be wearing a 3-piece suit and, you know, walk in and you're going to have every single person there trying to help you. If you don't believe me, try it sometime. Go to a car dealership just for fun. One day, walk in wearing like raggedy ass just clothes, just like your PJs and shit, and start looking at one of the more expensive cars. This happened to me, actually. I was at the Mercedes dealership getting my Mercedes serviced, and you know, we had just come from being out in the woods and camping and stuff like that, and I forgot the appointment was that Monday morning, and I went, so we're in like raggedy camping gear, and I had to bring the Mercedes to get the service check, right? And I went and I was looking at one of the, you know, newer, super fancy, you know, like $125,000 something Mercedes. And the guy came over and asked me not to touch it. Literally asked me not to touch it because he's like, you can't touch this. And I was like, why? And he's like, well, you know, he basically wanted to say, I don't think you can afford it, so don't even look at it. Which, you know, I'm not saying I can't afford it, but, you know, that's pretty freaking rude. My Mercedes was not cheap, so, you know, it wasn't a $120,000 car, but it wasn't a cheapo Mercedes. So where do you come off coming to me telling me that I can't afford something there, Carl? You know, so I wanted to talk about that kind of stereotypical pigeonholing people when it comes to, you know, not just sales, but everyday life. And, you know, I don't want to get into the topics of all the stuff that's going on right now. So, you know, I generally just mean things like where you look at somebody and you have that thought in your mind that like, oh, they're poor. Oh, they're this or oh, they're that. They're a jock. They're a cheerleader. They're the nerdy kid. They're the, you know, whatever it is. Those type of stereotypes, almost like those after it's still high school-y. But people still do it. And, you know, I've been a victim to it myself. So, you know, I'm not saying that, you know, I'm above any of this. I'm saying I've been a victim of it myself. I catch myself doing it, you know, here and there way, way less now. But back in the day, I used to do it a lot more. And, you know, I don't like it. I don't like that I used to do it. I don't think it should be done because, you know, I get it done to me a lot depending on how I dress or, you know, how I'm looking that day. You know, I want to be treated the same at all times. And I think that's really the problem with, you know, that leads to more and more stuff and what's going on with the world. Obviously, you know, thinking somebody's a jock or a cheerleader or a nerd or poor or rich based on what they're wearing or what classes they're in or what sports team they're on, you know, is not why we're having the problems we're having today. But I think that's a stepping stone that leads to it, like a gateway to, you know, bigger stereotypes, if you will. A gateway to racism. No, I don't know. It's like a gateway, though. So, you know, I look at it like this, and I like to tell this story where I had a lady come in one time that I used to be a part owner in some tanning salons. I used to be, you know, a big manager in those. I used to run a whole bunch of them, and I eventually did own one of my own, a couple of them. But anyways, with that said, before I was even an owner, I was, you know, a trainer, a sales trainer, a store manager, things like that. And shout out Tanrio. To my TR crew. So we used to, you know, we were the big dog salespeople, you know, when people came in. And there was this lady that used to come in. I'm not going to say her name or anything, but she used to drive like this, like old 70s beat up box Chevy truck. I mean, it was beat. And, you know, it sounded tough, had a great engine, you could tell, but it was beat. And the body was beat, the paint was dirty and rusted and things like that. It was beat. She would show up in like jean cut off shorts and like, you know, an old football jersey, you know, something like that. And, you know, she was a bigger lady and you know, an older lady. And she would come in, she would buy one tan all the time, like one spray tan or one cool bed tan or just one. And one day I got to actually, you know, be the one that talked to her. And I was like, hey, why do you always tend to just get one deal? Like, why do you only get one tan? We have packages, and you know, if you get more, if you buy them in bulk, you know, you're getting it cheaper. Like, think of Costco type of deal. And she was like, nobody's ever offered it to me before. So I started talking to her and going over the things, and she was my first platinum VIP sale that I ever had. My very first platinum VIP sale. Now, what the platinum VIP was back then, they didn't have the, you know, when I was doing it, they didn't have the whole you pay per month type of thing, you know, like your gym membership and your tanning membership. You didn't pay per month to be able to use whatever you wanted or unlimited. It was you paid this much money for just that. And when, you know, you if you paid $500, you had this many. And when that was out, you needed to pay $500 again or more. And the platinum VIP package was a $1,000 package. And it came with a whole bunch of stuff. I mean, it came with a bunch. And I'm not even gonna try and remember what all it came with, but it was a huge package, it was great. So me being who I am, I was just like, I'm not gonna stereotype her. I wanted to practice. This literally, I was thinking this was, so I guess I did kind of stereotype her even a little bit. I was like, I'm just gonna practice, but I'm gonna sell her a package because nobody's ever offered her one before. But I'm gonna start out like I always do. And I started out at the very top dog, the platinum VIP, the big dog package. And I pitched that, I went through my pitch, and I was getting ready, I finished my pitch, and I'm getting ready to shift gears and move down to the next thing, which was like 800, and then I was expecting to, okay, then we'll move to 6, and we'll go down, and maybe I'll get like a $200 deal out of this lady or something. So I'm getting ready to shift gears right away. And I finish, and I'm like, and she's like, okay, well, how much is all that? I go, well, normally, you know, if you bought all that at one tan at a time, it'd be like, you know, $4,200. But if you buy it all right now in bulk as a together package, that'll be $1,000. And that's our premium platinum rate. You get, you know, special days where stuff is discounted just for you and special offers because now you're a platinum VIP member. Nah, nah, nah. And I'm about to shift gears. And she goes, okay, I'll take that. And I, what? Yeah, no, I'll take that. And I went, okay. And she handed me a credit card right there. And she handed me a very, very nice American Express with a very high limit. And, you know, that's when I put in her name into the system and everything. And I went, oh my goodness, I know who this is. And I asked that, this is who you are? And she was like, yeah, nobody's ever recognized me around here. Well, the reason was is because she has she's a very wealthy lady. And, you know, but she loves that 1970s box Chevy truck. That was her dad's truck that he gave her. And she refurbished the engine and said, I don't need to do the paint and all that. It's my truck. I love that truck. I've been driving that truck since I was like 5 years old. My daddy used to let me sit and turn the wheel and stuff like that, you know, and this is how I want to remember the truck. So I keep it like that. I don't need to dress up just to show people I have money. And that was like, I mean, I was maybe 23 or 24 when that happened. And, you know, that really started to change my concept of people right there of thinking, you know what, you never, that whole don't judge the book by the cover. So, you know, think about that when you're out, you know, apply that to your daily life this weekend and see what it does for you. If you treat every single person like, you know, they're a platinum VIP member. Whether they're, you think they are or not, whether you think they have money or they don't, whether you think they like Star Trek and not Star Wars, you know, Star Wars and Star Trek fans, man, that's a clash right there. So if you're a Star Wars fan, treat them like they're a Star Wars fan, even if they're a Star Trek fan, and just see what happens. See the type of connection and the type of things you might be able to accomplish just by, you know, stepping out of your own stereotyping, and you do it subconsciously. So don't think it's like, you know, something that you do, you know, you have to think about it and not do it, but treat those people just exactly like they were all a Platinum VIP member. Every single person you come into contact with this weekend, and see what you might be able to accomplish. Because I'm telling you, these few things that we were able to pull off and put together for this week, if I would have looked at the couple of people that I talked to that have to do with putting this deal together from those sides, I would, if I would have done it my old way, the old way of thinking, I would have blown them off. Like, you know, I would have blown off the person who talked to me about banner season if I didn't, you know, not think about it in that way. And I treated that person like they were a Platinum VIP and went, I'm going to take the time to listen to what they say. You know, I don't really care about this $49 gold package to be able to get a bunch of specialized gifts. Like, you know, but okay, I'll listen to what you have to say, because I'm just going to sit back and listen and treat it like if I was excited about something, I'd like you to listen the same way. And I did that, and all of a sudden, by the end of it, I was like, dude, actually, we need that. Let's get it. So we ended up doing it. The same thing happened, you know, with quite a few things that happened with me today was, you know, with working with a team, some of the team was looking at going, I don't know if this is worth our time. I don't know if this is worth our effort. Should we really, you know, even do that? And I was like, hey, look, let's just give them the time of day. You know, let's treat it normal. It's, you know, not like we're going to have a whole bunch of time free any other time. We don't have time free today. We're not going to have time free on Monday. We're not going to have time free, you know. So we already got them on here. We're already listening to them. Let's just hear it out. And boom, we put together some really exciting stuff today. So that's my weekend inspiration. I know a lot of this talk was very businessy. I'm just really excited about it, you guys. I'm really excited about the stuff to come. So, you know, follow that up with treating everybody. Just try it for one weekend. What's the worst that can happen, right? The worst that can happen is you make some new friends, some new contacts, and you possibly make something else happen for your life that probably wouldn't have happened if you went along in your normal ways. So it's something about stepping outside and trying something different. Check it out. Do it. Let me know how it goes. If you're interested again in the beta project that we're working on, go ahead. Feel free to contact me again. If you don't know what Remind is or you want to know more about it, feel free to reach out and contact me. If you want to talk a little bit more about the ammo project, the guns and ammo project we're doing, feel free to reach out and contact me. And the very last thing, you guys, and I want you to enjoy the weekend after this, is make sure you go to Banner Seasons right now on the link I put in the comment. Sign up for the $49 gold package and get your business going and into the top-notch level, and get that stuff out there where you keep yourself the top of mind to every client and potential client you have out there. Have a great weekend, guys.